This week in Michigan, we had our first snow of the season. It is so cold right now, and it is only going to get worse. In our house, we use a kotatsu to keep warm. People are always asking how we got one in the United States because they want one for themselves, so here is a quick buying guide as well as some tips. For those of you who don't know, a kotatsu is a low Japanese table covered by a futon with a heating element underneath. Japanese homes typically don't have central heat or air, so they stick to just heating the room that they're currently using. So this is one way that they can keep warm while conserving electricity. Originally, kotatsu tables were heated by charcoal, but now modern ones use electric heaters. First of all, we would like to show you our kotatsu table. It's a Yamazin brand table with a room essence futon. The table is about 75 by 75 centimeters, and it's made of plastic, so it's maybe not the sturdiest on the market, but we haven't had any problems with it. The kotatsu is hooked up to electricity through an up-down converter. United States wall outlets put out 120 volts of electricity, whereas Japanese only put out 100. So this is a safety precaution to make sure we're not sending too much electricity to the heater. This kotatsu can get very warm, but the nice thing is that the heating element has a textured cover on it, so it doesn't burn if you accidentally bump it with your feet. There's also a knob on the side for adjusting how hot it is. I have never had to turn the table up more than halfway. I just don't need it that hot, personally. I really like to turn it on the lower settings and then fall asleep under it. That is so, so comfy. This table's top is also reversible, so you can have a dark gray top or a light gray top, just depending on whatever matches your decor or your mood, I guess. And then we also take the futon off the table in the summertime and just use it as a regular coffee table. We are super happy with this kotatsu. It is the perfect size for both Jake and I to sit under. I was worried it was going to be a little too small for me to sit under, but we have had no problems. Our buying guide is going to be focused on Amazon since that is where we got our table, but they're also available on eBay, and from what I've seen, the prices are fairly similar. However, tables and futons can greatly vary in price depending on what you want. For a setup similar to what we have, it'll be about $400 and hopefully a little bit less. The Yamazin table is typically on Amazon for between $150 and $200, including shipping. You can also find futons for about $80 to $100. There are some super cute Miyazaki futons on eBay. I want one so bad, but I've never seen one less than like $300. Then the up-down converters are usually between $80 and $100. As you may have noticed, modern kotatsu tables usually have a mat underneath, and we don't. We didn't get one to try to save some money, but we'll talk about that in the last section. My first tip is to save money before you buy. One of the most frustrating things when we were shopping for our kotatsu was that we'd choose a futon or choose a converter, and then we'd add it to our Amazon wishlist online, and then we'd go back in a week or two to check on it, and the item would suddenly be unavailable. For some reason, this seemed to happen most often with the futons. I found this really cute bunny futon that I had my heart set on, then it was unavailable, and I waited almost a half a year. And it never became available, and I never found another one like it. The gray Yamazin table that we have, I see it pretty often, but sometimes it varies in prices. So my next tip is, if you want this exact table and you see it for over $200, just wait. I'm confident that if you're buying around 2018, the price will go down and it'll certainly be between $150 and $200. I can't speak for later on, but right now, that is where I often see the prices. And I'm sure this goes without saying, but my third tip is make sure you read the descriptions, especially on eBay. It's not uncommon for a listing to show a picture of an entire kotatsu set, but it's only for the heater or only for the futon, so just make sure that you know exactly what you're buying. I hope I didn't shock you with that $400 price point, because I think kotatsus are great and I love having one in my home. There are a couple ways to try to save money. The first being that if you're a little crafty, you can totally build a table. I've seen just the heating element on eBay between $40 and $100. You could also use an old coffee table or an old dining room table, and you could turn this into a recycling project. Another option is just to skip the futon. This was our original plan. I was going to make a blanket, but you could also use a comforter or other blanket that you already have, just make sure it's not like those nylon sleeping bags that are flammable, because that would not be very smart. As mentioned earlier, we didn't get a mat to go under our kotatsu. I would like to get one eventually, but since we set our table on carpet, it's not a huge deal. Personally, I would not skip the up-down converter. You'll find varying opinions on the internet, and I'm really sorry, I'm not an expert in this area, and I don't want to give wrong advice. All I can say is that, personally, I wouldn't run my kotatsu without a converter. You just don't want to risk sending too much electricity into a heating element. We love having a kotatsu as a part of our home, but we know that buying one can be a little bit confusing. So I hope you found this information helpful. If you have any questions, please let me know. I'd love to help. If you haven't already, please subscribe to our channel. We typically make vlogs and other videos about our life and living with our pet bunnies and our dog. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.